What's up internet, I am Manish from rebellionwriter.com and I'm back with another PL SQL tutorial. As promised in the last video, today we will learn how to use multiple bind variables by applying using clause of execute immediate statement of native dynamic SQL. As this tutorial is in the continuation of the previous one, thus I suggest you to watch that video first for a better understanding. That being said, let's start the tutorial. So how are we going to learn this? You know what I was thinking? In the last video, we have seen how to use insert DML with execute immediate, right? So let's add some variety. How about today we use update DML for the demonstration? That way we can learn how to use multiple bind variables applying using clause as well as how to use update DML with execute immediate. Double benefits, right? I think it is an amazing idea. Let's do it then. So in the last video, we have created a table stu_info which had and still has one column, that is student name of varchar 2 data type. I have inserted a few rows into it. Let me quickly show you. Right. As you can see, we have 5 rows of data inserted into our table. And apparently, Leo is in the wrong class. Let's update this specific row and that too using bind variables with execute immediate of native dynamic SQL. So now we will write a very simple PL SQL program for native dynamic SQL. And I'm sure that will help you in understanding the concept in the easiest way. Let's write it then. First, let's prepare our update DML which we want to execute dynamically. I think we should close this output panel. Great. Now let's write the update DML. Here is our update DML. As you can see, using this statement, we are updating the data of student name column of our stu_info table. For doing that, we are using 2 bind variables, new name and old name. Again, make sure you don't end the DML with a semicolon. Now, let's quickly open a new worksheet and write our PL SQL block. Here is our fresh and crisp worksheet. Let's fill it with the code. Here is the declaration section of our PL SQL block. And like always, we have declared only one variable, which is sql_smt of varchar 2 data type, which we will be using for storing our SQL statement, which is an update DML that we just prepared. I have set the data width of this variable to 150, which I guess will be enough for holding our update DML. If in case it's not, then we could modify it later accordingly. You know what? I want you to set this data width to 10 in your code and then comment and tell me what was the error that you got. Now let's move ahead and write the execution section. Now let's quickly copy the update DML from the previous worksheet and paste it here. Done. Now let's enclose this SQL statement into a pair of single quotes. Great. And finally, let's end this assignment statement with a semicolon. Make sure the semicolon is placed outside the single quotes like we did here. Good. Now let's write the remaining line of quotes. Here is our main code where all the fun is happening. In this section, we have only 2 statements. The first one is the assignment statement where we are storing our update DML statement which we want to run with execute immediate into the variable sql_smt. The second one is the dynamic SQL statement. In this, we are executing the SQL query dynamically using execute immediate. As our SQL query consists of 2 bind variables, thus it becomes mandatory for us to list down the values for those bind variables beforehand. And you already know how we do that. Right. We do that by applying using clause. Here by applying using clause, we have specified the values that will substitute themselves in place of bind variables on execution. Let's understand it in a little bit more detail. So far in the previous tutorial, we learned how to use single bind variable with execute immediate. But here we have two bind variables. The rule remains the same regardless the number of bind variables. The rule states that unlike static SQL where we specify the values for bind variables after execution, in native dynamic SQL, we need to list down beforehand the values for all the bind variables used in the SQL query which we are planning to run with execute immediate. To do that, we take the help of using clause. We have already learned in the previous video that to list down all the values for bind variable used in the SQL query, we have to apply using clause with execute immediate statement. So you ask, Manish, what will happen if I don't specify the value for all the bind variables? Firstly, that's a very good question. Now, let's see what will happen if you don't specify the values for all the bind variables. Let's quickly modify this using clause and delete the second value, which is Leo. Done. What do you think? What will happen on execution? Let's see what possibilities we have. The first possibility is, like static SQL, we will get a pop-up box where we need to specify the missing value for bind variable. And the second possibility is, we will get an error. What do you guys think? Which option out of these two has higher chances? Whatever will it be, the good news is that right now you will learn something new, and that too using practical demonstration. Let's execute and see what will happen. We got an error. Not all variables bound. I guess we have seen this error already. It means in native dynamic SQL, specifying values beforehand for all the bind variables is mandatory. So let's undo the change we have made to this using clause. Great. I could have told you the answer directly, but I don't want to, because this way you will be better able to remember it. I'm not a big fan of conventional way of education. Anyways, let's move on to the next question. But first, let's close this output panel. So now you asked, but Manish, why didn't we use the bind variable for the table name? Once again, that is a very smart question. I really like you guys when you ask such smart questions. Let's find out the answer again in an unconventional way. So again, modify this update statement and replace this table name stu_info with a bind variable. Now that we have added another bind variable to our query, we need to specify the corresponding value in the using clause. The question arises here, where should we put the value for this bind variable tab_name? Should we write the value in the end of the list like this? Or can we write it down randomly anywhere in the list like this? No, you cannot write the values for your bind variables randomly anywhere in the list. The values which you are writing need to follow the order of the bind variables. Means the first value in the list of using clause gets assigned to the first bind variable in the query. Similarly, the second value gets assigned to the second bind variable in the list. Keeping that in mind, we can easily say that the value for the bind variable tab_name should be the first one in the list, as tab_name is the first bind variable in the query. So let's write our table name at the first place in the list of using clause. Once again, what do you guys think? Will it work or will we get an error? Let's execute and find out. Here we got an error. ORA00903 invalid table name. Yes, I know it is dynamic SQL, but that doesn't mean we start exploiting this dynamicity. Come on, do some work, don't be lazy. You know why we got this error? Let me tell you. There are few restrictions with Dynamic SQL. One of those is that we cannot use schema object name as bind argument in native Dynamic SQL. That means we cannot use bind variable to specify the name of a schema object like a table in execute immediate statement. So, with all these unconventional ways of understanding the concepts, we learned that first, it is mandatory for us to specify the values for all the bind variables in the list of using clause. Second, how the values from the list of using clause gets assigned to the variable. And third, that we cannot use bind variable for specifying any schema object name in native Dynamic SQL. After learning all these things, what do you think? Saying that native Dynamic SQL is not 100% dynamic will be correct or not? Comment and let me know your answers. Now let's undo all the changes and get back to our initial execute immediate statement, which actually was the correct version. But first, let's close this script output. Great. Let's get rid of this value using list sorted. Now, replace this bind variable with the name of table. Update DML also sorted. Once again, we have our correct version of the query. Let's execute this and see whether the records get updated or not. PL SQL procedure successfully completed. Finally, no errors. Let's quickly write a select statement to check whether the record number 3, which is the name Leo, is replaced by the name Strange or not. But first, let's close this output panel again. Done. Let's execute. Here is the result. So our third record, which was Leo, gets replaced with the name Strange, which means our Dynamic SQL program has been successfully executed. This is really a very detailed tutorial. I have given my best to make this tutorial as simple and easy to understand as possible. It definitely deserves your like and share. Please hit the thumbs up button and like this video and share it with your friends on your social media. Also, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. More such interesting content is already in line. Let's wind up for today. This is the tutorial on how to use multiple bind variables by applying using clause of execute immediate statement in native Dynamic SQL. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.